Amen.
Bless God. I didn't know I would be able to preach today. Amen. I was looking to be on half a tank until I saw my girlfriend walking in the door. Bless God. I'm good now. I saw the blue eyes walking here. Bless God. I'm blessed.
Yes.
Amen. For those of you who are not married, I've been married 31 years. So that means, amen, we grew up together. Somebody say amen. So I'm glad about it, amen. Amen. Sweetness walked in the room.
Hallelujah.
I'm glad about it.
Amen.
You can't talk like that when you ain't married now. Come on, pray here, man. Bless God. God is good. Hallelujah. Well, Pastor, what you talking about? Bless God. Then you got to be married to know what I'm talking about. Amen. God is good. I'm going to get right on to it. Can I get on right with it, bro?
Yes, sir.
All right. Bless God. Exodus chapter 33, amen. This is the foundation scriptures that I was given, amen. Many times we come in, you never hear the foundation scriptures. You know, people come in and they say, well, this is what I heard from the Lord, and they come up with something else, amen. I'm not going to do that tonight because I might, bless God. But I'm going by what I was given. Exodus 33, starting at verse 12. Moses said unto the Lord, see, thou sayest unto me, bring up this people, and thou hast not let me know whom thou wilt send with me. Yet thou hast said, I know thee by name, and thou hast also found grace in my sight.
Yes, yes, yes.
Now therefore I pray thee, if thou found grace in thy sight, show me now thy way, and that I may know thee, that I may find grace in thy sight, and consider that this nation is thy people. And he said, my presence shall go with thee. I will give thee rest. And he said unto him, if thou presence go not with me, carry us not up hence. For wherein shall it be known here that I and thy people have found grace in thy sight? Is it not that thou goest with us? So shall we be separated, I and thy people, from all the people that are upon the face of the earth. And the Lord said unto Moses, I will do this thing also that thou hast spoken, for thou hast found grace in my sight, and I know thee by name. And he saith, beseech thee, show me thy glory. Joshua chapter 1, starting at verse 5, working our way down to verse 9. These are the foundational scriptures for tonight. Joshua 1, verse 5 through 9. There shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with thee. I will not fail thee nor forsake thee. Be strong and of good courage. For unto this people shalt thou divide for an inheritance the land which I swear unto thy fathers to give them.
Hallelujah.
Only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do according to all the law which Moses my servant commanded thee. Turn not from it to the right hand or to the left, that thou mayest prosper whensoever thou goest. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth. If thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that they may observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then shalt thou make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. Have I not commanded thee, be strong and of good courage? Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee wheresoever thou goest. One more, Matthew chapter 17. We are in verse 1, Matthew 17, verse 1. These are the foundations tonight. Going down to verse 5. And after 6 days, Jesus taketh Peter, James, and John, his brother, and bringeth them up into the high mountain apart, and was transfigured before them, and his face did shine as the sun. And his raiment was white as the light. And behold, there appeared unto them Moses and Elias talking with him. And then answered Peter and said unto Jesus, Lord, is it good for us to be here? If thou wilt, let us make here three tabernacles, one for thee, and one for Moses, and one for Elias. While he yet spake, behold, a bright cloud overshadowed them, and a voice out of the cloud, which said, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear him. And for your, just for your interest, Acts chapter 1, verse 4. Acts chapter 1, verse 4. For your intelligent interest, Acts chapter 1, verse 4. We're going into verse 4 through 8, and being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which saith he, ye have heard of me, for John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence.
Amen.
When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom of Israel? And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons, which the Father hath put in his own power, but ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. And ye shall be witness unto me in both Jerusalem and to all Judea and Samaria and unto the othermost parts of the earth.
Amen.
The theme tonight is clarity, commitment, and power for a new beginning. The theme tonight, clarity, commitment, and power for a new beginning. This is the theme. If I was to give you a B thought for the theme of the A thought, it would be this church is on fire. This church is on fire. Amen. I'm not trying to be Alicia Keys, but this church is on fire. Clarity is defined as a quality of being, in being clear. Commitment is defined as being dedicated to a cause. Power is defined as the ability to do something in a particular way. New is defined as discovered recently or being used for the first time.
All right.
Being is defined as a point in time when something starts.
All right.
Altogether, this means I'm clearly dedicated to doing this a particular way, and this fresh beginning starts right now.
Yeah. Right now.
This church is on fire.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
The title of my message tonight, and I came for you, amen, to hear how we spread flowers over the pastor of this church. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
It is their 12th anniversary. Put your hands together for 12 years. Hallelujah. God is a good God. 12 years. Amen. Bless God. We've been, amen, married to the church for 12 years. You can't get folks to be married for 12 days. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
God is a good God. Amen. Pastor amen. Robinson. Bless God. Mother Robinson, would you raise your hand? The sermon tonight dedicated to you is you're just right for the job. You're just right for the job. Pastor Robinson, Mother Robinson, fellow members, amen, of this church, Bible Way Family, Radical Church, amen. We thank God for Capitol Rock being with us tonight and all other church being here with us, neighbors, saints, and friends. I stand tonight here with the monumental task, amen, of providing words of encouragement.
All right.
For the man of God in this place, amen, I've come to admire and respect.
Uh-huh.
I'm glad the man of God, amen, is humble, amen, in the sense of the word that he is the man of God.
Right.
So, Brother Robinson, anybody worth their salt, amen, would realize that without you, there would be no him.
Uh-huh.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Fact, amen, a lot of people would like to know, amen, what it takes to be a pastor's wife. It takes steadfastness. Unmovableness. Come on. You gotta always abound. Somebody say amen. Bless God. I see Mother Sexton, amen. She just shaking her head. She said, bless God, they only knew. Come on, somebody. I see my wife talking about bless God looking. She going, Amen. If you knew what it was to be a pastor's wife, amen, you run for cover. It takes a special kind of woman to be married to a pastor. Bless God, amen. You got to be half, amen, cute and half steel. Come on, somebody. You got to be a little hard. Come on, somebody. You got to be a little soft. Come on, somebody. Take a special kind of woman to be married. Thank you for being an example to the wives, amen, and the women of Bible Way and the Sierra Vista area, amen. So when I see you, Mother, bless God, I see you in all your regality, amen, as you walk through different stores and be in Walmart and walk through the post, amen, you still hold your head up, amen, in that Bible Way. Come on, somebody. From the beginning, amen, God has called men like Pastor Robinson to serve his people. Because God called Abraham, amen, he left his homeland. God called Moses, amen, and he declined Egypt and his riches. God called Joshua, amen, to destroy Jericho. God called, amen, Elijah, amen, he confronted King Ahab. God called Daniel, he faced the lion. God called James and John, they forsook their nets. John, amen, God gave, amen, Matthew a call, amen, and he left his token booth. Somebody say amen. Paul left a life of power and prestige, and Pastor Robinson, for those who don't know Elder Robinson, for those that don't know Minister Robinson, amen, was held in high regard at the Bible Way Parent Church. And this fine man of God, amen, felt the call of God, amen, to leave the Parent Church, come down here and be installed as the leader of Bible Way down here. That might pale in comparison to some of you, amen, for James, Paul, and John, amen. I'm sure, amen, they had things to do, but if you put it together, one, two, or three of you put it together, you'll find that Elder Robinson did just as well as they did.
Amen.
Truth of the matter, the days and times that we live in, amen, it seems like we need more men like Elder Robinson, amen? Just like Pastor Robinson. Tall timbers that are willing to stand the truth of God's word. We truly appreciate it. Pastor Robinson, Teacher Robinson, and may I say Superintendent. You thought I forgot, didn't you? Superintendent Robinson, it speaks for itself, amen. His credibility, amen. Pastor Robinson, you know as well as I do, amen, I don't even like to preach unless I give a text. Come on, somebody. This might be out of order for some of you, amen, but to make it order for me to do my job, and can I be myself? I'm not going to act like I'm back at Radical, amen. Bless God. You might get up and say, what is he doing, amen? Bless God. So I'm acting like I'm visiting, amen. God is good, but I'm going to put myself in a little bit, amen? Bless God. I need you to help me, amen, God, with this Paulian text, amen? Let's go ahead and break it over. We're going to unwrap this for a minute.
All right.
Philippians chapter 2, verse 19 through 22, we find these words. But I trust in the Lord Jesus. Y'all better get it.
All right.
Take your time. Somebody go ahead and get it, amen? Go again. Philippians chapter 2, verse 19. We're going 19 through 22. Amen. I want to unpack it.
All right.
Verse 19. But I trust in the Lord Jesus to send Timotheus shortly unto you, that I also may be of good comfort when I know your state. For I have no man like-minded who will naturally care for your state. For all seek their own, not the things which are Jesus Christ. Let me go to 21 again. I felt something move. For all seek their own, not the things which are Jesus Christ. But ye know the proof of him, that as a son with the Father, he hath served with me in the gospel.
All right, amen.
Pastor and Mother Robinson, I want to holler at you just a few minutes and encourage you in your heart from the following perspective. You're just right for the job.
Right.
Brothers and sisters, we live in a day where the word tolerance is being used at an alarming rate. The word tolerance is being used and abused. We're constantly being asked to lower our standards and lower our expectations. And to accept any old kind of behavior and any old body.
All right.
I'm a firm believer that is we need to pick the right folks that do the right job.
All right.
Now, if you don't believe me, watch this here now.
All right.
If you ever been sick and pain is running throughout your body, you're going to look for a physician, and any old doctor won't do. You're not going to look for just any old physician. You want somebody that's going to do the right job. Okay, that's not good enough. How about something wrong with your car? Now, many of you know that if you don't have a horse in Arizona, you're in trouble. Somebody say amen. So if you don't find the best mechanic, you're going to tell that tree-shade mechanic to get away from your car because you want somebody that can do the right job. Look at somebody say, he talking about you. He talking about you. You want the right job done. Yes, you do. I'm a firm believer it can be counted as a blessing if you can find somebody to do the right job. Well, with that attitude, the Apostle Paul is having the same type of thought in the text tonight. You see, Paul needed a leader, not just any old body, to do the job. Paul needed somebody that he could spend time with and check them out, and he wanted to send them, amen, to the church of Philippi.
All right.
So Paul was saying, I'm looking for somebody to do the right job. Why is this important? Because the Philippian church was good to Paul. Special to Paul. The Apostle Paul knew when nobody was standing by Paul, the Philippian church was there standing by him. Nobody else tried to help, they sent help. Nobody else was there to pat him on the back, they patted him on his back. So for instance, Paul is saying in this particular church that was planted, that was near and dear to his heart, that he didn't want to send any old body. Look at somebody say, any old body.
Any old body.
He was looking for somebody for just the right job. Now, you don't need to be haphazardly, amen, just selecting anybody. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
In Philippians 2:20, he says these words. For I have no man like-minded. Those of you familiar with this story, you find that there are hundreds of Christians in Rome. In fact, don't look at the Bible while I'm preaching on you. Don't look at it just yet. When you get home, you look at Romans chapter 16. You'll find out that Paul, amen, gives greetings to about 26 different people in chapter 16. How y'all doing? Hey, what's going on? Y'all doing all right? Hey, holla at you. But none of them folks was worth him sending.
All right now.
Where he was going. He knew him good too. Hey, you know how we do. But wasn't going to make them be sent.
All right.
Paul was saying, I searched and I can't find nobody that's just like me.
All right.
Nobody cares for you except for this one, and this young man's name is Timothy. Paul says in the letter to the church that in Philippi, get ready, I'm going to send you somebody. I'm going to send him to you because he's going to do the right job.
Yes.
Let me share with you real quickly. We'll let you go after this. Listen, Timothy was Christ-centered.
All right.
Yeah. How do you know? Look at Philippians chapter 2:21. Yeah. You can take my word for it. You can look at it, but look back up here. Paul said, for all seek their own.
All right.
Not the things which are of Jesus Christ. Seek themselves. Now some of y'all ain't gonna like
it.
Some of y'all gonna like it. I'm gonna stand by it now.
Come on, man.
Thank you, Jesus.
When we do our work as pastors, we work as hard as we can.
All right.
Come on, sir.
And then we go on home.
Yeah. All right.
I don't mean to our house either.
All right.
We work as hard as we can.
Come on, sir.
And then we go on home.
All right.
Now, I thank God for you. Because you do the work of God, and then you're going to take it on up out of here.
All right.
Ministers, you better get this. Pastors all should already got it. When you start saying, I have a ministry. This is my ministry. I'm doing my ministry. And you wrong for that. Because it's God's ministry. You know what I'm saying to you? It's going to be a wonder. I hope all of this can see it. It's going to be a wonder because I'm more closer, amen, to the mid-50s than I am to the 50s. Somebody say amen. Right. Listen to me. It's going to be a wonder to see folks that got itinerant ministries.
Yeah. All right. Come on.
When you supposed to come in, preach the folks to Jesus, and then you take it on in.
All right.
I'm going to tell you something that the Lord gave me about several years ago, bless God. God told me I was committing adultery.
Come on, sir.
I said, well, I ain't got no girlfriend. Yes, you got a girl.
All right.
You ain't got a girlfriend. Right. I ain't got no girlfriend. The church is my woman.
All right. Come on, sir.
It's my woman. Lynn is yours. Leave my woman alone. Preach to my woman and go home. I thank God for you. Preach the gospel, and then you minister to Mother Robinson. God take care of the rest of that. I need a man like Timothy that's like-minded like me. He'll preach the gospel to them. Somebody say amen. And let them go home. Go back. What's it about you? That's mine. And what we do is we spend too much time with the sheep. You got some stuff at home. I see it in the pretty color.
Jesus.
I got some stuff at home. Jesus. She wearing black and white like me. Look at it.
Jesus.
That's my stuff right there.
Lord.
It's belonging to God. Can I tell you something? Pastors, tell me if I'm wrong now. If you say, Pastor, stop preaching that gospel, go sit down somewhere. All pastors are professional plagiarists.
Come on,
it's not your word.
Come on, all right.
We're professional. Now, if we did this in college, we get thrown out of college. They would throw you out of college. This my ministry. I'm gonna preach my ministry. It's God's ministry. You're preaching His word. Nothing I said for the last 20 minutes was my word. I'm not saying my words now. Now when I put the mic down and sit down, I'm going to say what I want to say. Yes, they were preaching, but it seems to me like they had vain glory.
All right.
You might hear a whole lot of hooping. I'm not going to dog hooping.
All right.
I'm not. Because what it is we learn through our Africanus.
All right. Come on down.
That in the time of when we was picking cotton.
Come on now.
That we would pick cotton, pick cotton, pick cotton.
Praise God.
So then we kept that in our church.
All right.
Boy said, we gonna do it. He gonna make it happen. I'm gonna make it happen. I'm not making fun of that. It's good.
Amen.
It's all right.
All right. Amen.
But sometimes we do that because that's what you expect.
Come on. Too much.
And sometimes that's how we've been programmed. But sometimes we just need to get up. You the right man for the job. You get up, do what God say. And that's it. In other words, his position was not His agenda was not his position. Uh-huh. His aim was not his prosperity. Uh-huh. His ambition was not his popularity. Uh-huh. I'm gonna share something with you. If you very popular as a pastor, uh-huh. watch it.
All right now. Hallelujah. All right now.
Well, I don't know about that now. You know, I love to have 17,000 members. I love to have 17,000 members too, but whoa, when every man speak well of you.
Uh-huh. Right. Come on.
Right.
When you preach the gospel,
yes,
it's going to make some folks mad.
Amen. Amen.
Which one do you want? Amen. Barabbas or Jesus? Funny how we saying this during Good Friday. Watch this. How many know with a show of hands that the Jews meter out their own punishment? They will stone you in a lightning minute. Raise your hand if you know that. They meter out their own punishment.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's right.
So, thank God. I'd rather them do it, because if he is the Messiah, we just messed up if we do it.
Amen. Amen.
Which one do you want? Barabbas or Jesus? Give us Barabbas. Now, aren't you the same one that just healed the sick, raised the dead? Now, if I'm not mistaken, help me out, Bishop. If I'm not mistaken, the ones that really wanted him dead was probably the bakers. What do we have?
All right.
Five loaves and two fish. You better kill Jesus. I made bread. You better kill him.
All right.
What do we have? Five loaves and two fish. You know the fishermen said kill him. He taking their jobs. The undertaker said you better get rid of him. Lazarus is messing me up right now. He should have been dead. But he walking around and they want a refund.
God bless you.
They want a refund. You better kill Jesus. If you preaching the gospel, everybody ain't gonna pat you on the
back. Come on, man. Amen. Come on.
We love it when people do that.
Come on, Sam.
Hint, hint. Doesn't some of these attributes sound like somebody you know?
All right now.
We thank God for you. Don't talk about Timothy. Use him as an example. And all of that begs the question, what is it that makes Ernest Robinson just right for the job?
Let
me tell you why I think Ernest Robinson is just right for the job.
All right, come on, Pastor.
You see, the Lord showed me that you can join any church.
All right.
People church hop all the time. I believe that Easter is a good time for Sierra Vista.
Jesus. Jesus.
I done seen so many hoppers. I'm surprised they ain't gonna be bunnies on Sunday.
Jesus.
Folks go from one church.
Jesus. All right. Jesus. Wow.
Oh, God. They don't even mind hopping this year.
No, you don't.
Me, Lord Jesus. People hop church all the time. They get mad at one church.
Jesus.
A hot second.
Sure will. Yes, yes.
But when you preaching the truth, when they come up in here and see that tall timber, they know how to come in here with no mess.
Amen.
I thank God for you.
Amen.
You stand up in here.
Amen.
You stand up and hold on to the horns of the altar. Bless God.
Amen.
You ain't got to see every chair filled. You got to just see the ones that's in the chair filled.
Ooh.
You want a full church and don't have full people.
Hallelujah.
Come on in here, sir.
Yes.
rates, because I don't have a whole lot of folks.
Jesus.
But the ones I got, bless God,
Jesus.
And they do leave because they don't want to be thin.
Jesus.
Come on, sir.
Man riding down the road with a mule. It's getting late. You trying to make it to the bar. Sun dropped over the hill, the mule stopped. Yeah, mule, let's go. Mule wouldn't move. Man cracked, but come on, yeah, mule. Mule ain't. He get out and say, what's wrong with you? Mule look back and it's a bale of hay sitting on the road. Man said, mule, you scared of what you should be full of.
Ooh.
Whoa.
Ooh.
All right.
Young folks don't want to be full
of the Holy Ghost.
They just want to touch, but they don't want to be full. Full folks are coming. When they don't want to be filled, see, I'm glad about being filled. Because when you full, that means can't nothing else get in.
Come on now.
But they rather just have a touch so that they can have another touch.
All right.
Yeah.
Y'all say, come on.
Come on, sir.
You know. All
right.
You know, it's funny, right? We want God to touch us, but when we're not full, when I think about myself, some of y'all didn't get that? When I think about you, I touch my lips.
All right, now. Watch out.
Some of y'all will get that tomorrow. It'll be about 1 o'clock in the afternoon, you'll get that. Oh, I know what he's talking about.
Yes.
Look at somebody and say, you know what he's talking about. But the Lord said, I got some bigger plans for Sierra Vista, and you need a pastor that I'm going to appoint one to you to help guide you. To teach you, to encourage you, to pray with you, to equip you, so that you can do the things that I called you to do. You see, the Lord helped me to realize that people need a pastor, and in these last days, they need a pastor real bad. People need a pastor real bad. If you get mad at me, talk to my daddy. Talk to my daddy, you get mad at me. In the last days, it seems to be all right when the brothers come to church. In the last days now, they come to church and they say, Pastor Robinson, do you have any seats on the choir?
Glory. Jesus.
And they want you to accept that.
All right, come on.
And then the daughters come up and say, Pastor Robinson.
Jesus.
Come on, family.
Jesus.
You're supposed to accept that.
All right.
You'll get that tomorrow, too.
Jesus.
Churches are many. Pastors are few.
Yes.
You see, as a matter of God in the ministry, I've come to ask myself, where would Joshua be without Moses? Where would Timothy be without Paul? Where would the disciples be without Jesus? Churches are many. Pastors are few. What does this mean? It means finding a church home becomes secondary, and finding a pastor becomes primary. A lot of people want to go because that church, ooh, that's a nice looking building.
All right, come on.
They want to find a church. But you need to find a pastor.
All right.
See, when you find a pastor, the church don't feed you.
Whoa.
The pastor feeds you.
Whoa.
A lot of folks will ride past this. But the ones that want a pastor will see what's buried. See what's buried.
All right.
Keep it burned.
Amen.
Keep it burned.
Yes, sir.
It's all right to find a pastor.
Amen.
Some of you look puzzled. I can see your faces. I see. I thought the building was supposed to be now. Black folks. Bishop Seymour preached out of a barn.
All right.
Antiquity said he still had hay in the hayloft.
All right. All right. Yes.
1906, three blocks away. Folks was falling out of the Holy Ghost.
Jesus, glory.
They were falling out of the Holy Ghost. They was trying to get to the church, and they was crawling to the church. Crawling in the street. What's wrong with you? Are you drunk? They say, I ain't had a drink, but I can't even make it no more. Because they're trying to get, the Holy Ghost was that power.
My God. My God.
It wasn't the building, it was the man of God.
Yeah.
What's it about to
be? My God. That's good, Pastor.
My God.
Thank you, Jesus.
We're finding the right pastor. P-A-S-T-O-R.
All right.
That God assigns you. If you came here vaginally,
Jesus.
Vaginally. Grow up. If you came here vaginally,
Jesus.
Or by cesarean.
Glory.
All right. Talk to the children later, baby.
All right now.
You didn't have a clue who you was coming to.
No.
It's funny how you 7 pounds, 8 ounces, and to the right of you is a millionaire's child.
All right.
And to the left of you is a crackhead baby.
All right.
Yeah. But you somewhere in between.
Yeah, all right.
You didn't get a chance to pick your family. When you looked up, see, when I was born, some of y'all don't know what this is, but when I was born, they put me in a dresser drawer.
All right.
All right. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. They have a bassinet. They got the bottom drawer. You know how you got the little ones? Yeah. They take the ones at the bottom, that's deep, that's deeper. Come on here, sir. And then they pad it. And they put the baby in the bottom drawer. Now they don't close the drawer now. They put the baby on top of it. Come on in here. Come on in here. Catch up now. Catch up. Catch up. They don't close the drawer. They take the drawer and put it on top of the dresser.
All right.
Come on in here.
Glory
to
God.
Come on here.
Jesus.
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 Point being, I didn't pick my family. But we need to stop picking pastors too.
Come on.
God assigned you. Pastor.
Right.
When he assigned you, how many of y'all remember about maybe 10 years ago, 11, yeah, about 10, 15 years? Little 13-year-old boy wanted to divorce his family.
Yeah.
How are you gonna divorce your mom and dad?
Yeah.
Now some of y'all ain't gonna like this, but
in black households, when you want to divorce your family?
Yeah.
It's working. You gonna divorce me? I'll tell you what you're gonna do. Go back in your room. Go back in your room.
CPN. Oh my God.
Yes.
Forgive them.
Come here, mother. I didn't say break their legs, I said tear their hands up.
Jesus. Right. Glory.
All right. When you will automatically you get the right pastor, then you automatically in the right pasture.
All right, all right.
P-A-S-T-U-R-E.
All right.
What we're doing is we're picking pastures.
All right.
I'm going to tell you how that messes you up, and I'm shutting down.
That's good. Thank you, Lord.
God said, it's time for me and you to part ways.
All right.
Our herdsman is getting in too much fracas. Where do you want to go? I'll let you pick first.
Amen. All right, all right.
Dirt, mountains, more dirt, more mountains. Dirt, dirt, dirt. Mountain, mountain, mountain. Oh, I want this green part.
All right. All right.
All right.
All right. All right.
What you gonna get? I'll take the rest of the dirt.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you, Jesus.
So the man of God just stand there and watch his kinfolk going down to the green spot. Shortly later, that green spot catching on fire.
Oh, yeah.
I think they called it Sodom and Gomorrah. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You'll pick Sodom and Gomorrah if you're not careful, because you wanted to pick a green pasture and not get a good pasture. I want a good pasture, not a green pasture. Somebody say amen. I'm definitely going to shut down right here. Is this all right? It's a lot of brothers in here. I'm going to say this right now. Brothers, that's the same equivalent for picking a woman.
All right.
Hips, lips, and fingertips. That's green pasture. But you want what God got for you. You'll mess around and get Sodom and Gomorrah and anything else that comes with it when you want hips, lips, and fingertips. You better pick that one right there. Well, this one is a Coca-Cola bottle. And that's a 2-liter Pepsi. If you do the math, brother, you get more soda with a 2-liter Pepsi. Can you do the regular Coke?
All right.
Oh, we thank you right now. We give God the honor and the glory.
Yes.
For the man of God.
Yes.
We honor him, God.
Yes.
We give you the praise for him.
Yes.
Strengthen him.
Yes.
Honor him even the more.
Bishop Sexton, who else in the house in our ministries? Amen. All right. All right. All right. I'll let Pastor Bishop Sexton come and say a quick word.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
He already gave it.
Amen. Any other ministers have a word you want to say? Amen. God bless you. God bless you. All right. We are so grateful that you guys came tonight.
Amen.
Amen. So grateful that you fill our pews. Amen. And so in the future, my pastor always told me, if you want to have friends, you got to show yourself friends.
Amen.
And he taught me that at a very early age. And so it is my heart's desire to fellowship with as many churches in this city who wants to fellowship.
Amen.
And of course, we're there, as the pastor said, there's a standard now. And the standard is righteousness.
Yes,
just as he said, we just came get with anybody and everybody.
Come
and that's not being, in my view,
amen,
in my understanding, that's not being arrogant or obnoxious.
Amen.
I think the scripture says, know them among whom you labor.
Cautious,
and who are over you in the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
So I got plenty of coverage. I have plenty of, God bless you, with great coverage. But I look to men like Bishop Sexton and Bishop, amen, from the seed of Abraham. Give me his name, y'all. Amen. I'm 67. My name's Smith. Can you give me a little grace? Amen. He preached a dynamite message last
Sunday. Amen.
Amen. And his church was here. And we just enjoyed the Lord last night. We had fellowship afterwards. And we're going to do so tonight in the name of the Lord. We're getting ready to release you. Amen. And before you go, Brother Robinson and those wants to set up a little table back there, and you can take something with you, some refreshment. Amen. Take it with you and stay here, eat it, fellowship, whatever your heart's desire.
Amen.
All right, our hearts and minds are clear, let us stand. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Lift your hands. Father, we bless you and thank you for what our ears have heard tonight and our hearts have received. Father, we have praised you in song. The fruits of our lips.
Yes.
And we give you great praise right now.
Yes.
And God, we ask you to bless this food, even though it is just refreshment, bless it, sanctify it, that it may be used for the strengthening of our body.
Yes.
And we'll give you great praise. Amen. And we love you and thank you in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
All right. Those of you at the family.